the co-founder and faculty advisor of PolyMatters, Youth Matters chapter based in the same university and active since 2016 with collaborative projects. She will be presenting the work today, but there are other co-authors in the paper, all from the same institution, and from PolyMatters, Lorenzo Stucchi, Gorica Bratic, Zina Jovanovic, Chiara Ponti, Ludovico Giorgio Aldo Biaggi, and Mario Antonio Brovelli. So thank you, and the screen is yours.
Thank you for the introduction. Okay, good morning, good afternoon, good evening, everyone from Italy. It's really a great pleasure and honor to be here with you alongside so many inspiring and diverse voices at Phosphor-G. I'm Federica Gaspari, one of the faculty advisors of PolyMatters, and I'm here today to present the result of our works in innovative teaching on behalf of the entire team of PolyMatters. This presentation so will focus on the collaborative humanitarian mapping course that took place at Politecnico di Milano last year. Here's a brief summary of the presentation with an initial introduction of the group, PolyMatters, who we are, what we do, and what we plan to do in the future. Then I will present you the context and the objectives of the collaborative and humanitarian mapping. I will go deeper in details on the structure of this course, extracurricular course at the university. And then in the end, we will focus on the evaluation of the activities of the students enrolled on the course with some feedback from them and also some conclusion and lesson learned for the future. So PolyMatters is a group of students, volunteer students and supporting member also from outside Politecnico di Milano, but mainly students from Politecnico di Milano, active since 2016 as the first European chapter from the Youth Mapper network. The main goal of the group is the promotion of mapping and in particular the use of free and open source technologies to do it, with a special focus on OpenStreetMap related tool. The group is composed by a wide variety of students coming from different backgrounds, from architecture, design, engineering, so so many expertise involved in these kind of activities. We were born as a group active in in-person meeting since 2016, but also due to the pandemic of the last month and last year, we switched also to a virtual meeting, all focused not only on field mapping for obvious reason, but also on remote mapping, mappathons, and many collaboration with other groups, association, and organization active in the field of humanitarian and collaborative mapping. Last year, we were involved with the support of the Master of Science in Geoinformatics Engineer of Politecnico di Milano in the design of an extracurricular course as part of the Passion in Action catalog by Politecnico di Milano. This catalog includes all the extracurricular activities that can be done at our university, and all the Politecnico di Milano students enrolled at the end can also have their activities recognized inside the diploma supplement at the end of their university studies. The idea for this course was to combine innovative teaching and active learning focused on geospatial topics with a particular approach related to collaborative and FOSS culture with, again, a special focus on OpenStreetMap related tool. At the end, the course was entitled Collaborative and Humanitarian Mapping, and it aimed to introduce students from different backgrounds to the potential and the importance of open data, high quality open data, OpenStreetMap and FOSS tool, while building a students-led community. Also, because at the end they had the opportunity to join the group, and in particular, one important thing about this course is that each lesson and webinar was conducted by a member of PolyMatters, so students currently enrolled also at Politecnico di Milano. So here's the structure of the course that consisted in a total of 20 hours, divided into seven meetings that were dedicated to the students at the beginning, because at the beginning we planned to do it in person last year, but due to the emergency situation, we switched online, and also because we saw a lot of interest within the Youth Mapper networks with promotion on social media and on the web, we decided to open this course to everyone interested. So we had a lot of students and attendants from all over the world that brought their voice and their experience in the conversation. Each meeting consisted in mainly three sessions. One was dedicated to, a first part was dedicated to an introduction to the concept of mapping on a particular topic with application example and case studies. Then there was a practical session with dedicated mapping task. And in conclusion, we had Q&A, question and answer session for the attendants that maybe had some doubts or curiosity on what we talked about. At the end of each meeting, some homework were assigned also to quantify the contribution of the students, giving them also a quantitative threshold in order to have an idea of their actual works and activities, and also having the opportunity to give them some feedback during the entire process. So, as I told you, all this lesson was remote and were live streamed on a video teleconference platform and also on social media. And we were really happy to have many guests from different fields, from association and organization active on the geospatial and humanitarian fields. So we had the opportunity to talk and discuss about important topic with many experienced contributor on OpenStreetMap and not only. So let's go, let's dive deeper on the content of each lesson. The first one, of course, was an introduction to OpenStreetMap, because we decided to organize a gradually increasing in terms of complexity and also difficulty learning journey for the students. This first meeting was organized with the participation of Dimitris Karakostis from World Food Program, that with his special contribution highlighted the importance of open geographical data and volunteering mapping, especially in the context of humanitarian field crisis mapping, with a special focus on the Syria activities. The aim of this meeting was to highlight the importance of open data, and also for this reason the meeting and organization was supported by the Open Knowledge Foundation with an Open Data Day grant, mini grant. And in conclusion, all the activities were dedicated to the mapping and digitizing of buildings in the area of Tartus in Syria, where WFP is active at the moment. In the end, we recorded a really incredible number of contributions with more than 4,000 buildings in the area. Then, in the second meeting that was part of the Polymappers project awarded with the Youth Mappers Research Fellowship in 2019, we started mapping in Brazil using a more advanced tool for OpenStreetMap editing, that is JOSM. So we switched from ID to JOSM, and we started mapping in the context of deforestation, so highlighting the importance of this kind of data on land use and land cover in the field of climate change awareness, and also as an idea to keep up to date the data in this area that are particularly affected by this problem. We mapped in the area of Mato Grosso, and in conclusion, students had the opportunity to learn more about how to map roads, so more complicated feature to be mapped instead of buildings, also land use and rivers, understanding the importance of the direction of waterways and their kind of classification. Then, in the third meeting, we fly virtually to Colombia for a project that was part of the master thesis project developed in collaboration with IMMM Design Lab that is based at Politecnico di Milano and was focused on urban planning and slum upgrading in informal neighborhood in the border between Bogota and Soacha. For this meeting, we decided to focus on the importance also of a street-level imagery and collaborative street-level imagery using the Mapillary application that was used in collaboration with TECHO, a humanitarian association active in Latin America, that collaborated with us and after some joint training started capturing street level imagery in the area and then uploaded this data, the important data, on the Mapillary database. So in a second moment with our meeting, we were able to map points of interest starting from the images with the help also of the contribution of local mappers and volunteers from TECHO that helped us to identify how to map these places, in particular shops, amenities, and healthcare. Then we focus more in the activities and project developed by some organization like Map for Future, dedicated to humanitarian mapping. This organization, based in Rome, in 2020 developed a collaboration with an internal international cooperation project with Geocadastral Service in Somaliland. And the goal of this project that is still ongoing is the realization of a geoportal for the city of Argesia. So students during this meeting had the opportunity to learn more about this project directly from the people involved and also understanding the how an international project is supported and coordinated in time. And after that, they started mapping on a task dedicated to the identification of areas of private properties in the vicinity of the city of Guajale. So we recorded more than 14,000 map changes in the area. Then also UN mappers, as part of the Unite Maps initiatives based in Brindisi in Italy, took part in our course with a presentation by Michael Montani and a tutorial by Rachele Amerini on the importance of providing up-to-date and high-quality base map using OpenStreetMap data. So students learn that their contribution can really make the difference, also helping peacekeeping missions and operation in the area of Sudan, for example, where the mapping task was located. In this occasion, students and attendants had started mapping and digitizing many OSM features with a special focus on highways and waterways. And this case helped raise the attention also on the importance of semantic tag for classification of highways that always involved an important attention to these details. We reached again important results with 8 kilometers squared of land use mapped and more than 500 kilometers of highways mapped. And so we went back to Italy with a project born at Politecnico di Milano and developed by Lorenzo Stucchi, that is actually a member of Polymappers, and supported by many local associations devoted to accessibility. So we started highlighting the importance also to include an attention to mapping accessibility in OpenStreetMap with this project called Via Libera that combined the use of Mapillary with the use of JOSM to map accessibility related to features like sidewalks and crossing. The result of this presentation consisted also on highlights on the current status of the project that involves also not only students from university with our course and activities, but also students from high schools and primary schools. And after our mapathon in May, we recorded 20 kilometers of sidewalk and crossing mapped in Milano. The last meeting was more a sort of a conclusion of what we discussed in the previous one, and in particular, we were really happy to have as guests Miriam Gonzalez and Geoffrey Catterega from Humanitarian OpenStreetMap team that highlighted the dynamics of the humanitarian mapping communities with a special focus on the importance of good quality data in emergency context. So in this occasion, students had the opportunity to discuss with the guest about these topics, understanding how a project is developed in time, supported by organization, and also how to engage a community in this type of collaborative project. So they also started sharing some ideas on future projects for university, maybe for thesis project and purposes, but also local project involving their communities. At the end, students were asked to answer a feedback questionnaire in order to have also, as polymappers, an idea of what we could improve maybe for the next version of the course. So, in conclusion, we had highlighted 6 mapping tasks in 7 meetings for 61 students, Politecnico di Milano enrolled students, focused on different topics and also geographical context, highlighting also the difference and the importance of context when mapping. We had an average of 30 contributors per meeting and a total of an average total of 1,000 map change set that were validated by polymappers member after each meeting, giving feedback to the students and also giving congratulations in case that their mapping was really good and well detailed. It's also nice to highlight the final achievement of the enrolled students that, as we said, were asked also to fulfill some threshold requests related to the homework of mapping. And in conclusion, we had an average of 60% of students that were able to complete the course, reaching the presence frequency, but also the mapping request. So here's the result of the feedback from the students' questionnaire. We saw that the majority of them heard about our course through the promotion by professor at Politecnico, but also outside Politecnico, thanks to a network of organization and groups involved in the development of the course. But also many of them heard about us through the Politecnico website and Polymapper social media with the help of the Youth Mappers Network promotion network. And so the majority of the students, however, was part of Politecnico di Milano. And we saw that many of them were able to attend the event without any particular problem of connection and also attendance with contribution during the discussion and Q&A sessions. So we also were really interested in knowing their experience and level of experience in OpenStreetMap. So in the questionnaire, there was also the opportunity to know more about their background. And we saw that mainly they were divided into 3 main groups, from beginner to intermediate mapper, but none of them at the beginning considered themselves as a really expert mapper. So we were really happy to see at the end that they were more confident with the activities and were really interested in developing a personal project and other collaborative projects. As we said, Polymappers involved a wide variety of academic track and university track, from architecture to design and engineering. So not all the students were really part of the geospatial engineering, geoinformatic engineering track, but the majority of them, however, at the end said that no prior knowledge was required and everything was explained in a clear enough way during the meeting, also the geospatial basic and content. In conclusion, we see that this course that we aim to provide again in the next years was dedicated and well appreciated by students with different level of experience and a diverse background related to OpenStreetMap, and also this learning journey supported by feedback and dedicated webinar and session on practical application developed as an increasing level of complexity in terms of tools, map, feature and topics can be suitable for our possible extracurricular activities, also to foster transversal skills and critical thinking on the students that at the end, as we said, were also more interested in developing collaborative tools and also were more aware of the importance of local knowledge in relation with global community involvement and also global collaborative project. That in this way also learn more about this from guests that were able to share their experience, but also while gaining first-hand experience with mapping tasks and with mapping project that could help in a concrete way also many communities. So thanks for your attention for this presentation. You can even find more about our project and task on the Polymappers GitHub website.
Thank you, Federica. Thanks for the great presentation and sharing the great results. We have a couple of thumbs up from the chat from the attendees. So very impressive results and well done and a great job. So thanks for the comments as well. One question there is, how can one collaborate with you to offer a similar course or program at a different university in a different country?
Oh, we are always open to collaboration, so we would be really happy if you can contact us through our website or our social media platform. We are on Twitter, LinkedIn, Facebook, and other platform, Twitch also. You can contact us through our mail, polymappers@gmail.com. And so we are really interested to know more about possible future project together.
Sorry, I was just writing the email to the chat box.
Thank you so much.
One personal question. So I'm also, I'm trying to integrate OpenStreetMap and OpenGIS tools in the courses that I'm teaching at the university. And what is your experience with especially students outside of the discipline, outside of the GIS or geography discipline? So What are the challenges that you have faced to lift them up, rise them up to a level of mapping quality data?
Okay, thanks for the question. It's really a great question, especially because in the past and also for the future meetings, we always try to ask ourselves how to structure meetings and our program and activities, considering that we have a really diverse background within our attendance, usually, and our audience for activities. In general, we focus more on the application and on the team of the mapping, on the collaborative mapping, and then we highlight the potential potential of this open data. So when we have an audience that is both a beginner, so it's the first time, it's the first experience with no geospatial background or knowledge of GIS, alongside other members that maybe are more experienced, more skilled also in the field of GIS, we usually structure, let's say, different paths, but that can be that are crucial, both crucial for the development of a project, with some kind of tutoring, also with more experienced mappers and contributors that helps with the basics, other new attendants, also with some small challenge or paying attention to the quality, also the contribution, highlighting the importance of tags, how they can be used for different applications. And so it is, I think, an increasing and gradually progressive, let's say, learning journey that should be shared together, also in the philosophy of a collaborative project. And each member that is part of it can grow and gain experience also from different background and different experiences. So the tutoring approach, I think, it's a key element also in this kind of activities.
Okay. Thank you. Great to hear. And one extra question there from the audience now.
Okay.
How do you distribute or assign tasks to people? Do you prepare areas beforehand?
Sorry, I think I didn't get the last part.
Do you prepare the areas to work with before the, yeah, so what tools are you using to distribute and assign tasks to people, the questions?
Okay, we took advantage of the main Tasking Manager platform made available by TeachOSM, OT Tasking Manager. So we developed our task on this environment with the classic template of tiles and small square tasks, where students were able to map with in an area entirely dedicated to him, her, or them. And also we give them feedback using OSM chat tools, also commenting their mapping chain set. We had also a collection of their OSM usernames that they submitted at the moment of the enrollment. And so we were able to track their activity and their the evolution of their contribution. We saw that at the beginning they had some, they made the classic beginner errors, maybe related to one squared building. This is like a nightmare for OpenStreetMap validators, for example. And going on with time and meetings, they were able to map also more complex and detailed element, paying really attention to the different, let's say, shades of meanings, also to particular tags, in particular for the point of interest mapping activities. It was very difficult to face both the difficulty of local knowledge, because the Spanish language was the local language for Bogota, and we had we thanked for this a lot to the local mappers members that helped us in coordinating everything without making mistakes. This is always an important question that should be asked when developing this kind of project. So I think that in general, the complete process consisted in developing a dedicated task, also suitable for all the different map features and state of the evolution of the mapping path of the contributor. We've always support on feedback and exchange of experience opinions between tutor, Polymappers members, and new members that attended the meetings.
Thank you. I have also shared the link of the Tasking Manager to the chat for people to access. You're welcome. And thanks for the great presentation. It was very good to hear about the activities. Thank you. Please feel free to get in touch.